Okay, go. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Okay, let's talk.
Let's talk.
Clearly, I'm not at home in my. Do I say studio? It's not in my studio. I'm with my homegirl Alex.
We're on location.
We're on location. And ew, I hate that I changed the way that I started talking as soon as we got on my channel. And
you have your band.
Yeah. But that's not my brand, that's not me! Anyway, we already started this mukbang, and we're talking about pride!
I stunty cunty, I feel like a queen. Isn't that gay pride, bitch? That's sissy! That's a sissy, bitch! Sissy, bitch! Binica.
It's June! It's June, and as I noted in the other half of the video, I'm turning 30 this month. And we're celebrating Pride Month, so today's topic is Pride.
And Pride stories.
Right, so if you want to see the first half of our mukbang, go to Alex's channel. I will link it down below, link it up above, I will link it here. I will say, where is the body?
Where is the body?
So,
okay, you read one and then let's go. Let's get into it. Oh, and we're eating watermelon and we're drinking
strawberry matcha. With coconut milk. Bitch, it's good.
Mm-hmm.
That's my new drink.
This is it.
All summer 19. Okay, so I have a response from at Sir Frederick W. She also does drag as Sir Ava, so check her out. I asked, tell us a pride story, what was your first pride like, or and he said it was Black Gay Pride in LA when he was 18. I honestly didn't even know there was a Black Gay Pride, and I kind of need to go, that's crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was like, oh my god, tell me about it. He says it's too much to type. Anyway, this bitch said it was kind of like a scene from Noah's Ark. Did you see Noah's Ark? Not Noah's Ark, the biblical thing. Not the religious one, no, the gay black show Noah's Ark.
Oh, yeah, no, I haven't seen it.
Yeah, I'm gonna put a clip of it.
So, I like your script. I just think you could mix it up a bit. Maybe make one of the characters gay. The cop's partner, maybe. What are you smiling about?
You always want to make it gay.
So?
So you don't need to define your work by your sexuality.
You write scripts about black folk. Are you defining your work by your raciality?
I write white characters, too.
I write straight characters, too. I was always taught to follow my passions.
Is that the end of the story?
Yeah, that was it.
Okay, let me do one.
Okay.
This is from at So What Blow Me.
On Twitter.
Yeah. Okay, so last year Pride, I was in Berlin and I got drunk as shit and decided to perform Do You Wanna Touch by Joan Jett. Do you know that song?
Uh-uh.
Don't know it. Ooh, it must be foreign. I turned it into a strip show. Oh, I wish I was there for that. I got to my underwear and I was wearing jocks. Oh, classic. Good for you, I love that. The crowd went nuts. When the song was done, I dropped the mic, although they said not to. I was just drunk, apologized for the host, and drag queen spanked my ass.
I'm so sorry to the host and the drag queens.
But perform a strip show for me. Okay.
Your turn. This is from Instagram. From @ I'm gonna spell it, J-E-B-F-F-F-F, Jeff Finnerman. She's being messy too. So her first Pride was 19 or 20 years old.
Uh-huh.
And she danced in the LA Pride Parade, blacked out in the afternoon, lost my phone and wallet and the people I was with. # I don't like prides. Can you imagine just going down route all of a sudden.
And
remember where you are. You wake up and you're like, I don't know where I am. I was just going down the parade route, and now I'm...
Oh, okay, so this is my friend Michael.
Okay.
I just texted him. But I think his Instagram is, it's Michael Owens.
Okay.
It was like 5 years ago, but basically it was the rich gays versus the poor gays at Pride.
Wait, at what Pride? At LA?
Pride, probably. Oh, yeah, and I was the one in the middle with the white flag and sort of united everyone.
Oh,
so bringing the poor gays and the rich gays.
I got a response from... Never mind, I'm not gonna put it. From Princess, it was inappropriate.
My first Pride, I got called a Nick.
So we were watching videos, and Alex's roommate brought up a really like interesting and like valid point, is that when straight people are at Pride festivals, remember that it is about pride. It's mm-hmm. about celebrating the LGBTQIA community, and it's not about you. It's not about wanting to like
have a good night out.
Drink and party with your friends. Yes, you're drinking and partying with us. You're having a great time because mm-hmm. you are an ally
yes.
for people who are marginalized, and not because you are just out there trying to get a good Instagram photo and say, oh, I went to Pride and I wore a rainbow. Like, you are welcomed. You are welcomed with open arms.
Accepted.
Like, yay! Yay!
I would love to have a lot of allies, but sometimes people come with their own agendas and don't come with agendas that like align with what Pride is about. And, you know, Pride is not just a huge party. It is being present, it's being seen, and knowing that yes, we are marginalized, but
we are thriving.
We are here.
We're growing, we're mm-hmm. making progress.
Right.
We are celebrating the wins and the losses.
Right, it's not about just like, hey bitch, yes girl, yes squad, all that. Like, yeah niece, we love that part, but also there are struggles that we have to go through every single day to just live, you know? Sometimes you have to go to work and realize that like, someone may not accept who you are or accept what you're doing for them just because of your sexuality or the way that you're presenting yourself, your gender, your gender identity, your outward expression, just because of that way. And Pride is really a time where you can like, this is who the fuck I am. This is who I wanna be. And I'm out here celebrating myself. So if you are straight and coming to Pride, or anyone who's coming to Pride, know that it is about celebrating everyone and celebrating yourself and who you are, and not about just drinking and getting fucked up. Mm-hmm. But drink and get fucked up, you know?
Yes.
She doesn't drink, but...
Get your orange juice.
Right.
Yeah!
Have a good little green juice and like... Have a great fucking time, because it is time. We've been cooped up all winter long, and I know California is not the perfect example of that, because it's like...
These winters are brutal.
Right. No, it's not, bitch. She hates when it's like 60 degrees outside. She's like, oh,
no, fuck.
But like, we have a time to be free and be who we are, and June is that time to celebrate it. Really, every fucking day is that time to celebrate it. And if you're proud of yourself, be proud of yourself every day, not just during Pride Month. But while we're here during Pride Month, celebrate each other.
You are fucking,
well, I don't know.
You really did too.
Just make more podcasts.
You're just juicy.
Oh, where is the body?
Okay. This is from... Jeremy Brownies on Twitter. Hey girl. I went to my first drag show last year to see Mayhem Miller. That's fun.
She's cute.
Okay, cool. and I had such a great time. My friend that basically chaperoned me had to like get in between a girl that was trying to booty dance on me. Oh my god. This was like my first time ever being in a bar experience, and he saved me from them, but they were great, and it was this awesome experience. I even got to meet Mayhem and told her that it was my first drag show, and she welcomed me to the community. That's like so cute. Like a little like coming out party with Mayhem Miller.
Oh, is he gay?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, fun!
Yeah.
Welcome everyone. Welcome to the club.
Welcome to the party.
Right.
Welcome to Body.
I feel like Pride is also a time when a lot of people start coming out because
they're
able to see, like,
yeah.
Hey, there's other people who are out there that may be like me. I don't know how I feel, but I may feel like this, and then they end up being like, this is who I am. These are the people I want to be around.
Mm-hmm.
And like, gays are so magnetic that like, people want to be
all
around.
All my friends be gay.
Ooh, not all my.
Hi, straighties. Hi, straighties.
Oh my god, like ladies and straighties.
Ladies and straighties.
Hi, straighties.
Okay, let's move on.
Okay, but let's talk about this.
Okay.
I am not one. I realize that we have a flag here, a rainbow flag. I've never been that girl to like be really into like rainbow and like flags and like.
Like at Pride or in
just
their
in
life.
General, I am like a homosexual man, but like I'm not someone who's. This is my very first ever Pride flag that I've ever
purchased,
had, owned,
mm-hmm.
waved. Like I've never done that, and I'm not ashamed of it. It's not like I'm like, oh my god, I hate the rainbow or whatever. It just doesn't define me. Yes, it is a Pride thing, but I feel like. I don't have to walk around and have it, you know? And I do appreciate when people do have it. Like when I walk around, I live in a very gay neighborhood and I live in a very gay neighborhood. And when I walk down the streets and I see people who hanging their gay flags or trans flags or bi flags, all of the type of flags, I'm like, yes, you do it. Me personally, that's just not me. I don't do it. I will now, I have this little one. And,
yes.
My husband and I will
put it in your P.O. box.
We'll probably put it like in our living room or something, but it's not something that, I am so like,
adamant
about having. But what I wanted to say about that is, there are so many companies now, like we just went to the mall, and at the mall, a lot of stores had their
corporate
it says
pride.
Just like rainbow and a pride, it's just a black shirt, and like, or like it's got rainbow sequins on it, and it's like everything is a rainbow. I only saw one shirt that was not, or one clothing item that was not just a rainbow.
Yeah.
And like, it was equality, which is great, fine, but like, why can't there be clothing made for the gays that isn't
specifically just like
right
a rainbow?
Why can't? Anyway,
no, I know what you mean. It's like the default is just to slap a rainbow on
right.
it and call it pride merchandise, mm-hmm. and we support you, and mm-hmm. like there it is.
Right, and I saw a tweet that was saying something like this, and I was like, I don't know if I agree, but now I really do agree that like, just because you're selling us t-shirts and pants and rainbow shit all over the place, and having that right when you walk in
mm-hmm.
to say yes, we're celebrating Pride, that's awesome.
Yeah.
For the first time ever, Disney has put out a Pride line, and Disneyland Paris is gonna have their first Pride festival in the park. Great, fantastic. But I'm hoping that this is again an opportunity for other people to be exposed to the LGBTQIA plus in world, and not just like, oh, the gays and they got their fucking rainbows out again and it's June, you know, like, no, we really want it to be, I want it to be something else, and I don't want to give my money to someone who's just going to give my money back to someone who doesn't want me to be gay.
Yeah.
I want to give my money to someone who is going
Ooh, she's
to
about to stop.
Who's going to help me be who I am. Yeah, I really think that like, I think that it's important when you're celebrating Pride and you're buying these Pride outfits or whatever, it's not just about the outfit. You want to support, you want to buy something that is supporting the group that you are wearing.
Yeah.
That makes sense? Mm-hmm. I don't want to just buy something just for corporate. And my friend Lauren has a organization called We... So my friend Lauren has a organization called We All Need Allies. You really need to check them out. They're on Instagram at We All Need Allies, and they have products and clothes that you can wear for Pride that's not rainbows. They have rainbows, I'm looking at it right now, but like it's not something that you have to say like rainbow. And it goes to queer people. It's queer people making things for queer people. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
and
yeah,
like,
yeah,
but queer is another thing that we won't talk about now. But like, it's great. It's great that there's queer people making things for queer people. So I think that's awesome. And that's what Pride is about. And it's not about, whether everyone has the same H&M shirt or not.
Yeah, no, that's true.
So,
with that being said, because the battery is about to die,
we're all done with this mukbang.
Mukbang.
Who do you think ate the most watermelon? Leave a comment in the comment below. Leave a comment below and tell me who you thought
ate the most watermelon.
Ate the most watermelon. Okay.
Kim.
Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video and want to see more videos about sexuality, sex, and relationships, please, please, please subscribe to my channel and oh yes, thumbs up. I don't know why I need a thumbs up. Like
I don't know.
She's not monetized, so I don't really care.
Whatever.
If you like it, share it. Whatever. Let's have a great Pride month. Want to follow him on Instagram? You can follow him at
Africa.
If you wanna check out his videos, he does ASMR. He does like funny shit and like really good content. You can subscribe to him at
Alexander Huafei.
And I will link him down below because he has the first half of this mukbang. And if you want to follow me on Instagram or Twitter, you can follow me at Greg Scott.
With two G's.
With two G's.
Yes.
And an underscore. Greg.
Underscore Scott.
Underscore Scott. I mean, I'm going to put it right
just
here.
Put it there.
So, that's the end of this video. My scalp is itchy. Bye.